Discover why you should visit Corcovado National Park, which is the best station to visit based on your expectation, when is the best time of the year to go, and the best tours we recommend you to do. Why should you visit Corcovado National Park? Number one question, because Corcovado has all the necessary ingredients to create an epic vacation. For instance, incredible landscape that combines beaches, jungles, and rivers, waterfalls to perfection, exciting adventures such as chasing, footprints, and finding exotic animals, incredible sunset and sunrise. In other words, Corcovado is the best place to visit if you want to feel alive and enrich your life story with epic adventures of exploration and excitement. Some interesting facts about Corcovado National Park. It was considered the best natural park in the world by Discovery Corporation in 2017 and 2018. 99% of Corcovado has no trails. It's the best park for wildlife viewing in tropical Americas. In one day, you can see more mammals in Corcovado than in 10 days in the rest of Costa Rica. Everything about ranger stations in Corcovado and how to choose the right one for you. Corcovado has 6 ranger stations, 3 inland and 3 in front of the beach. The most popular and recommended stations are the ones located in front of the beach. That is San Pedrillo to the north, Sirena in the middle, and La Leona in the south. La Leona and Sirena are the stations that once had the most impact by humans because they were small towns in them. However, humans left in 1975, and after that the forest started to regenerate. Nowadays, these areas are covered by secondary forest, and the trees of secondary forest produce many fruits and flowers because their life strategy is to grow and reproduce fast. Consequently, these forests are very dynamic and very good for observing animals. Also, Sirena has even more animals than La Leona because it is located between 2 rivers and the sea. These 3 water elements produce biological barriers that concentrate numerous species within them. For that reason, Sirena is the most popular and most visited station among Corcovado. And the station we recommend to visit if you are looking for short animal center hikes, especially if you are a wildlife photographer or if you come with a family and you want easy hikes. On the other hand, there is San Pedrillo, which has a primary forest where trees are so tall that cover the sunlight, waterfalls, rocky beaches, and magical landscape. Here's where you can have incredible hikes through exuberant jungles and virgin beaches. San Pedrillo is ideal for hikers and explorers looking for more physical challenge and less travel trails. What is the best time of the year to visit Corcovado? There are 2 seasons in Costa Rica, dry and rainy season. Firstly, in the dry season, from December to April 15, it might vary, the tours are easier because rainfall is very low. However, it is also more touristy, and that may lose a little bit of the charm. It is a good time for photography due to abundant light. On the other hand, the rainy season extends from April 15 to December 15. Water is life, and is what allows Corcovado to keep the wild exuberant. Also, during this time, Corcovado has more original charm and is less touristy and wilder. As for animals, they are wild and natural. There is to say that it is completely unpredictable, and it, regardless of dry or rainy season, a good day is a good day to see animals. If you want to see real wildlife, there must be some risk. A good adventure has, as a part of the ingredients, a controlled level of risk. Despite of everything, the tourist activity is very regulated, and in 7 years of guiding, I have never had any accident with my clients that require medical attention or have called a situation that have forced us to cancel the tour. Ideally, the company you use for the tours should have guides certified in first aid and CPR, as well as an emergency and safety protocols. What are the best tours we recommend you doing? We always recommend doing the overnights because it is undoubtedly the best way to enjoy the best natural park in the world, and allows you to feel the adventure and the jungle and let it catapult in the memories. We'll seek to make you have a story to tell, to turn you into a storyteller. There are 2 kind of overnights that I recommend you to do. Let me clarify, this is a personal opinion based on my experience as a guide and the comments of our clients. To recommend an overnight, I take into account 3 important factors. The companion you come with, either children, seniors, photographers, if you are a passive or active tourist, or what is your physical condition, and if your focus is more in wildlife or adventure. For people who come with children, senior, I recommend more passive, taking passive hikes It is a good tour to take it easy and learn about forests and observe many animals. It is also perfect for wildlife photographers and people focusing on seeing as much animals and learning from the forest as possible. If you are more active and like to explore and live adventures, meet explorers and adventure people, I recommend you to do Sirena and San Pedrillo overnight, where you can observe the animals of Sirena and walk the wild trails with waterfalls, lush forests, and pristine beaches of San Pedrillo. To find out more about our tours in Corcovado, click on the links of the description. It will be a pleasure for me and my team to guide you in the best natural park of the world. Pura vida.